Let us first see what the problem is with cache coherence. That is, do we even need cache coherence? Our programmer is expecting to see shared memory behavior. That means that when one core writes, let's say, 15 to a variable, and then another core reads that variable, it will read what the last write put there. This is how cores communicate through shared memory. One writes something to a shared memory address, another one reads it and expects to see the data that was written there. But in our hardware, each core has its own cache. And we need cores to have their own caches at least in the level 1, because a single large level 1 cache would be too slow and would not have enough throughput to keep up with the requests from all of the cores. So because we cannot do this, we have private or per core L1 caches, so each core has its own. However, once you have these private caches, here is what can happen. This is the core A with the level 1 cache for core A. This is core B, and it has its own level 1 cache. So we said that, let's say, core A writes x equals 15. Suppose this is a cache miss. We use the address of x to index into our cache, check the tag whether it corresponds to x, and then if this is a cache miss, we go to our main memory and fetch the whole block into our cache. Let's say that in this block x is 0. Once we fetch it into our cache, we write our 15 here, so now we have a 15 in our cache here. Now let's say that core B wants to read x, so it wants to see what x is. It uses the address of x to index into its own cache, sees that it doesn't have what it's looking for there, and reads the block from main memory. This block here has 0 for x still, because we didn't write back from A's cache yet. So we end up reading 0, which is not correct. And note that this doesn't occur only the first time when we have a cache miss. From now on, A can write to its own L1 cache many, many times, B can read from its own cache many, many times, A will keep writing to its cache and not updating memory, B will keep reading from its cache and not checking back from memory, because once we bring it into the cache, it's going to be a hit. B is never modifying it, it's always going to read 0, no matter how many times A writes 15 or something else here. So obviously, we are not getting the communication of data we want from A's writes to B's reads, and thus our shared memory doesn't work. When we get in a shared memory system behavior like this, we say that it is incoherent. The same memory location, as seen from different cores, can have different values, which is not what should be happening in a shared memory. In order to not get an incoherent system, we need an active approach to cache coherence that will make this whole thing behave as a single memory, even though in reality there are multiple copies of the data floating around.